We have statewide management plans that have areas that we can move sheep to within the state. And we find appropriate habitat for bighorn sheep. These are desert bighorn sheep. And there's a lot of planning. And then we start working with other states or areas that have a surplus of bighorn sheep. These sheep are from Nevada. We caught them off of two different mountain ranges. One just east of Las Vegas in the River Mountains, just on the outskirts of Henderson. It's an unhunted population where they have a lot of sheep. Then the other ones are the Muddy Mountains, which is, we based right near the Valley of Fire. And those sheep also are doing very well.
Utah and Oz is always really good for funding on this, and I'm sure that's where the bulk of the funds came for this. They put up the money and we coordinate with Nevada and pay for the capture, and that's basically how we, if they have animals available, we pay for them, and that's how it goes.
We do have a lot of unoccupied sheep habitat that we would like to fill in those areas. Sometimes water is a limiting factor. There's a lot of things that we can do to create new water developments that can open up an area, a new area.
Ledgy, rocky, cliffy terrain, you know, where there's a sparse shrub and grass growth. Escape terrain is a very big thing for them. These sheep will eat shrubs and grasses and forbs, you know, if they're available. Water is very important, less so than it is for other big game species. These sheep, they're a desert type, and sometimes they won't water for 3 or 4 days, but if they have water within 3 or 4 days away from where they're at, they'll be just fine. There's a possibility of having mountain lions, cougars in the area, bobcats could be in the area, and coyotes would be the predators, and of course, you know, humans is a possibility too. There are already open permits on this unit, and these sheep would be available to hunting come next hunting season. We're winding down right now. The one thing that will let these sheep go for a few years is that the rams that we did release into this group here are younger rams, and the hunters are usually very selective, only taking, you know, rams that are 6 to 8 years old, where these rams are only yearlings. So, you know, in 6 to 8 years, some of these rams that were released here and any newborns will be available and open for harvest.
Sheep are native right here. This is just a little bit lower density of a sheep area. It's great habitat for them. They'll just fill it in pretty naturally. The last time we released some, it was only a matter of weeks until they found a few other sheep. The density is lower, but they're really social animal and they'll find each other pretty quickly. What we're trying to do is restore them to their native habitat, and by doing that we'll be increasing hunting and viewing opportunities and for the general public. We're on the Grand Staircase-Escalante National Monument, which is it's a great place to have a bunch of different diverse species of wildlife, and bighorn sheep are a really charismatic species, and so it's a really good thing to have them here for everyone to enjoy. So what we're just trying to do is just increase them where we've got the available habitat to what they probably were historically at one point.